Pollyanna laughed. He was such a funny man, she thought. The next day she saw him again. "'Tisn't quite so nice as yesterday, but it's pretty nice," she called out cheerfully.
"Eh?"
"Oh," grunted the man as before, and once again Pollyanna laughed happily. When, for the third time, Pollyanna accosted him in much the same manner, the man stopped abruptly.
"See here, child, who are you, and why are you speaking to me every day?"
"I'm Pollyanna Whittier, and I thought you looked lonesome. I'm so glad you stopped. Now we're introduced. Only I don't know your name yet."
"Well, of all the—"
The man did not finish his sentence, but strode on faster than ever. Pollyanna looked after him with a disappointed droop to her usually smiling lips. Maybe he didn't understand, but that was only half an introduction. "I don't know his name yet," she murmured as she proceeded on her way. Pollyanna was carrying calf's foot jelly to Mrs. Snow today. Miss Polly Harrington always sent something to Mrs. Snow once a week. She said she thought that it was her duty, inasmuch as Mrs. Snow was poor, sick, and a member of her church. It was the duty of all the church members to look out for her, of course. Miss Polly did her duty by Mrs. Snow, usually on Thursday afternoons, not personally, but through Nancy. Today Pollyanna had begged the privilege, and Nancy had promptly given it to her in accordance with Miss Polly's orders. "And it's glad I am to get rid of it," Nancy had declared in private afterwards to Pollyanna. "Though it's a shame to be tucking the job off to you, poor lamb, so it is, it is. But I'd love to do it, Nancy." "Well, you won't, after you done it once," predicted Nancy sourly.
"Why not?"
"Because nobody does. If folks wasn't sorry for her, there wouldn't be a soul go near her from morning till night. She's that cantankerous. All is, I pity her daughter what has to take care of her."
"But why, Nancy?"
Nancy shrugged her shoulders. "Well, in plain words, it's just that nothing whatever has happened right in Miss Snow's eyes. Even the days of the week ain't run to her mind. If it's Monday, she's bound to say she wished 'twas Sunday, and if you take her jelly, you're pretty sure to hear she wanted chicken. But if you did bring her chicken, she'd be just hankering for lamb broth."
"Why, what a funny woman," laughed Pollyanna. "I think I shall like to go see her. She must be so surprising and different. I love different folks."
"Huh. Well, Miss Snow's different, all right. I hope for the sake of the rest of us," Nancy had finished grimly.
Pollyanna was thinking of these remarks today as she turned in at the gate of the shabby little cottage. Her eyes were quite sparkling indeed at the prospect of meeting this different Mrs. Snow.